Valley-esque. But I guess we'll see once we get into it. Tip, some trees can be foraged. Centers it. Is that what it does? Okay. This book will guide you through your first steps and give you advice throughout your journey, so don't forget to check in now and then. On the left, you can see each chapter of the book. However, you'll also notice that most of them are locked for now. Sometimes completing a chapter will earn you a reward. These will appear in the box on the right side of the guidebook. Take this apple to restore some lost HP. To eat the apple, right-click on it in your bag. You can open and close the book by clicking on the closed book icon on the left of the screen or with the X button in the top right corner. You can also move this menu around the screen with the green button in the top right corner. Give it a go. If you want to center the panel, you can do it by pressing the brown button on the top right corner. Underneath the guidebook, on the left side of the screen, you can see the required steps to complete each chapter. There's a strange man with a parrot waiting to speak to you outside of the house. When someone has something to say to you, a text bubble will appear above them. Let's go speak to the stranger. Leave the house via the front door, right-click on the man with the parrot, and talk to him. You can now close the book. Right, let's claim the apple, and close the book. Go outside and meet Captain Farrell. Whoops. Avastji Landlubber, how are you feeling? Last night was pretty rough. You got caught up in a pretty nasty storm out there. Your boat crashed on the nearby rocks. I guess you don't remember a thing. I found you unconscious this morning here on the beach. You must have hit your head. By the way, do you want some of my famous fish stew? It should help that headache disappear. Ignore the smell. It tastes better than it smells, I promise. So about that boat you came in last night. It be in terrible shape. I don't think you can use it as it be for now. Or you can, actually, for firewood. Anyway, you need a place to stay, kid. Go north and speak with Ava. She will be the one with the blue hair. You can't miss her. You'll probably find her near the town hall. She'd be the mayor of this place. You can also check your magic compass if you need any help finding someone. Now where be my other shoe? Okay, so we can go here. Captain Farrell said you should head north into town and meet a woman with blue hair. She's the mayor of this town called Pixelshire. Apparently she should have some answers as to where I am and how I got here. Travel up the north road and search for the blue-haired woman. You will collect items from the ground automatically when you are close to them and have enough space in your inventory. Items will be stored inside your bags that can be seen at the bottom right of your screen. You can either press B to open all the bags at once or click on a specific bag to open it. The amount of bags you have and inventory space available will increase when equipping more and better bags. To use an item, right-click on it in your inventory. Drink the health potion to restore your HP. So, if we click on this bag. Okay, and there's nothing in that one, I guess. And what's this? Crafting. Cool. If we... Why? Okay, it's trying to tell me to go north. I think that's a bug. She is. Hi, how are you? Feeling better? I'm Ava, by the way. I'm the mayor of Pixelshire, although there aren't many citizens at the moment. Captain Farrell told me he found you unconscious this morning at the beach. I'm so glad that you're okay. trying our best to build a new community, but sadly things aren't going very well. We came here as a group of refugees from El Beret in search of something better. Have you heard of it? It's a faraway continent, deep past the Sonora Sea. Or Sonora Ocean, sorry. El Beret was once a beautiful and prosperous continent, but anyway, enough of that for now. You'll need a place to stay if you want to join us. To make a house, we'll need a lot of wood, which we can't gather ourselves. Our logger, Jack, could help you with that, but he didn't come back last night. You would have to explore the forest to the west, over the stone bridge, to find better quality wood. He's still out there. I hope he's alright. Hey, could you go out and help Margarita with her crops? That says Margarita, right? Okay. It's about time for the harvest, so she may need a helping hand. She's a lovely girl with blonde hair. You can't miss her. I'll see you later. I need to speak with Valerie about Jack. Okay, we have a health potion now. Where's our HP? Okay, so we do. Oh, there we go. We used it. Not a cue. There's no way that's a cue. she said she would sell me the rest. Oh, but I have to harvest her tomatoes, which are here. Hello, puppy. Can you move? Okay, is the dog supposed to be there? Am I supposed to go in here? Open Margarita's notebook. Right-click on her. Okay. The Greenwood Forest is just to the west of here, on your left, just after the bridge. Take Margarita's quest from the top. From the quest tab. This it is. Help me harvest those tomatoes outside my house, and I will give you some seeds in return. Okay, I'll accept that. Buy and equip a watering can from the shop tab. Is that this one? Okay, how much money do I have? 500. Okay, let me buy one of those. Buy and then equip one of those, and then buy some tomato seeds. Raspberry, cabbage. Here. Just one. Good job. Now go find an empty spot. No, the ground. Plant the seeds and don't forget to water them. Seeds won't grow until, without water. After that, do me a favor and harvest some of my tomatoes. I've already planted 3 of them. They should be ready by now. Okay. Equip and create some farmland using the hoe. Townsfolk will often have jobs for you which may reward you with gold, items, experience, or friendship. These jobs are either normal quests, daily quests, or important story quests. Normal quests are marked yellow and will unlock depending on your friendship level with the person. Daily quests are marked blue and will appear randomly across each person. Important quests are marked red, and you will need to complete these quests in order to progress the story. Take and complete Margarita's quest Harvest to complete this chapter. You'll need to buy a watering can for Margarita. You will find it in her shop, the last tab of Margarita's Townsfolk panel. In order to accept a quest from a townsfolk, you will need to right-click on them when you are nearby and select the exclamation mark icon. This will take you to the quest menu. You can see and select the available quests from the left page of this menu. On the right page, you will see quests, rewards, and the completion requirements. You can also see the progress of all the quests you have accepted in your quest log by pressing J. When you are ready to complete a quest, you will need to speak with the original quest giver. Open the quest menu and click complete. Take the hoe and equip it, and select the tool in the radial menu queue and start hoeing. Drag the seeds from your inventory and plant it on the soil. Place on the soil to plant them. Go plant these tomato seeds then. Am I meant to be able to get past the dog? Because I can't. And I also don't want to just go around planting stuff wherever. Can I really not? Is the dog meant to be here? Like, it feels like a purposeful thing to block you off. I'm just gonna plant them here. I don't want... Oh, I can plant them there. No, I'll plant them here. I don't really want to. I don't like that noise. There we go. And then water the seed. Okay, and now I need to... Oh, okay. Maybe it was there on purpose. There we go. Oops. Okay, we've got a bunch of tomatoes, and then go and complete Margarita's quest. Go over to her... quest. Master Farmer in the making. Those tomatoes will do a tasty sauce for my pasta. Speak to you later then. Okay, and now we go and talk to Eva. Oh, I can still talk when... Or I can still walk when that menu is up. I don't know, I meant to be able to do that. Okay. ask about it. She seemed pretty angry. The rest of us are not trained to use any kind of weapon. You had a sword when we found you by the beach. I hope you remember how to use it. Valerie has the sword. I believe she said something about repairing it. Please find her and help us find Jack. Her house is to the east of here. You'll see a house that looks like a stone tower. I know I'm asking a lot. I'll continue to work on your house blueprint while you're gone. Good luck. Okay, now let's read this. Looks like the town is in need of some help, and Ava has asked if you can lend a hand. First, you'll have to find Valerie, the warrior and protector of Pixelshire. Every townsfolk in Pixelshire has proficiency, a service they provide for the town. You met Margarita before. She's the agronomist. I've never seen this word in my life. I cannot figure it out. Agronomist, to say farmer, or I don't know. I know agriculture, so I feel like it is a word. Obviously it's a word, otherwise they wouldn't use it, but I can't say it. Agronomist, and looks after farmland. Captain Farrell is the fisherman, and Valerie is the warrior and master swordsman. That dog is freaking out. Go east and find Valerie. Check your compass if you get lost. After equipping your sword from Valerie, you can see everything equipped in your tool belt by pressing C. Here you can see the current durability of all your tools slash weapons. Once the bar is completely red, the tool slash weapon will be broken and cannot be used again unless repaired. Select the sword as your active tool by opening the radial menu with Q and selecting it. Right click when you are close to an enemy to attack. The better your sword, the more damage you'll inflict. You can also dodge enemy attacks with space. Okay, let's go meet Valerie, they said. East. Have I been looking at the compass wrong? Why is it moving? Oh, well, this is Valerie. Hey, you, hold it. Who goes there? That's you, the new face. I'm Valerie, the warrior around here. I already know about Jack. Unfortunately, I can't leave the settlement unguarded and roam around looking for him. You look like someone who can handle themselves. There are only some slimes in the west. They should be easy enough to defeat in combat. I repaired the sword we found you with. You might need it to defend yourself. Here, take it. Do you remember how to use it? Equip the sword to the weapon slot first, then. You do know how to use it, don't you? Stick him with the pointy end. Left click. You can also dodge space. It should be easy enough to handle. Try it on the dummy near the fountain. Remember to use a health potion if you are low on health. Your sword can also be used to cut down grass if you need to. Good luck out there. Okay, let's equip that. Oh, we have potato seeds. I must have gotten that from request. Let's equip the sword. And where's the dummy? That's a dog. It's sitting near the fountain. Defeated, every enemy will drop a chest containing items. This can be looted chance of being a critical hit, which will inflict double the damage. If your HP reaches zero, you will faint and you will respawn in town with less money as you had to pay to be rescued. So, what is that potion that we just got? This is a stamina potion. It replenishes stamina. Pass the bridge to the west. Just this way. Thank you. safe. Thanks again for the help. Home sweet home. Speaking of home, do you have a house here in Pixelshire? I can help you build one. You'll have to get a blueprint from Ava first, as the mayor shall have to approve it and whatnot. We'll speak later about that. Okay. We found a Jack. Thanks to you, Jack is safe. Now you need him to follow you back to Pixelshire. In order to do this, right click on Jack and click the follow button. Now he'll follow you home. Every townsperson has their own house. You will also need to build your own. Ava can give you the blueprint for your first house. Some recipes will also require you to have a blueprint in order to build or craft them. Other recipes will require the previous tier of the item to upgrade them. For example, to upgrade your house to level 2, you'll need to have the level 1 house first. Okay. Oh, there's our durability on our sword. So, what do I do? Talk to Ava. Hello? I'm so happy that Jack is okay. Okay, let's get you settled in. I have the blueprint for your first house ready. It's more of a tent than an actual house, but you'll be able to upgrade it later. I hope you like it. Please speak with Jack. He will help you gather the rest of the materials and make a workbench. You will also need to find Braun if you need any metals for upgrades. He's usually in the mines to the north. But you can leave Braun for later. Speak with Jack first. Oh, I got the blueprints. That is a dog. Oh, those are stairs. That's cute. It said... Oh, that shows me where my objective is, okay. So, he's this way. I love that little picture up there. Will it tell me if I've gone past him? With someone to enter their house. Alright. This is a good area to plant some crops. I don't really... This looks like a blacksmith or whatever it was that Jack is. Okay, help. As previously mentioned, every townsfolk has their own profession. Some of them can help you out directly by following you and helping you with your tasks. Big Jack is a logger, so he can help you cut down trees if your friendship level is high enough. To cut down a tree, simply equip the axe by selecting the tool with the radial key menu, stand next to a tree and right-click it to hit it. Jack will do the same if he's with you. If your tool breaks, you can buy a new one from the townsfolk. Let's just read this now. Wood is an essential part of the crafting system. You will need a lot of it in order to craft various recipes. You can see your crafting recipes by pressing G, but in order to craft something, you will need to be close to a bench. You already have a workbench as a gift from the previous task. Place it in an open area and right-click on it to see available recipes. On the top right side of the crafting panel, you will see a bench icon. This will be red if you are not close enough, or green if you are close enough. Okay, I need to find Jack. It does point. Okay, so I just hadn't gone far enough. Me pet the dog. That's Margarita. Oh, this is his house. Okay. Oh. And now he's this way. I don't believe that. Is he just in here? Yeah, he's up there. Okay. Let's go speak with Jack. Hello. We'll need a lot of planks to build your house, but I can help you with that. I am a lumberjack after all. Oh, that's why he's named Jack. Next, you need to place a workbench down in order to transform wood into planks. Oh, I nearly forgot. You can't chop down trees with your bare hands. Here, take this wooden axe. It's pretty simple, but we'll choose a top. It will do the job for now. Just stand next to a tree and hit it with the sharp edge until it falls down. If I'm with you, I'll help out. After that, you'll need to place a workbench down in order to transform the wood into planks. Let me know if you need help. Okay. Chop an oak. Green leaf tree, okay. Let me get the axe. And a green leaf tree, is that one of these too small? to chop down. Oh, it's different woods. Oh, that one's blue. That's cool. Oh, there's a tree. Tree guy. Oh, the stamina goes down very fast. I think those... No, I don't think they do move. I am very confused. Go kill 3 blue slimes, then report back to me. Ava and Jack mentioned a miner called Braun. He spends his time within the mines of Pixelshire. Go north and search for the entrance to the mines near the waterfall. The continent of Arcadia is full of mines. Nearly every area has a dark cave with precious ore inside. These magical caves tend to change shape from time to time, and they also magically replenish their ore deposits. However, be very careful in there. Precious ores can also attract dangerous creatures. Does she have a different one? She does. Okay, I don't know about the way that those progress, I'll be honest. Good day. You did great with cutting those trees down and crafting the planks. Unfortunately, I can't help you with the rest of the materials, as I am out of ores. So yeah, now comes the tricky part. You'll need to speak with that grumpy old miner, Braun. this time in that dark mine up north. You'll find the entrance near the waterfall. Good luck with him. Okay. And you need some iron again, which I do not have access to yet, and you still want carrots. I think it's because I accepted her quest. It thought it was done, except that it wasn't done. I accepted it and then didn't get a chance. What on earth is that? Alright. Oh. There's Bron. Bron Thunderbeard, I love him. Why, who are you? You ain't gonna take any gold from me, you ore thief. What? Oh, you're the new guy. Well, that doesn't change much. You keep your hands in your pockets. So I'm Bron Thunderbeard, and I am the town miner. If you want some stone and copper to build an house, you'll need to mine it for yourself. It's not so hard to stand next to stone and whack it with pickaxe until it breaks. I don't think I'm gonna try his accent. You know the different colors of ores, don't you? Now this is the real problem. There's something lurking inside this cave. I daren't go too deep to find out what, but maybe you can. Put that fancy sword of yours to good use if you find anything strange. Stick to mining coppers, as I don't think you can mine iron just yet, but maybe I could teach you how if you help me with some things. Good luck. Remember to pick up your pickaxe and equip it. Oh, I didn't equip the hammer either. Right, let's grab this. Oh, and here's a daily quest as well. I got some tools to need fixing, but I need some more ores to get the job done. Fetch me some iron and copper and I'll make it worthwhile. Okay. Alright, can I get these mushrooms? Oh, I can. Oh, I cannot get that though. Please. Alright. What's this? Can't get that either. Skeleton bones and a skeleton skull. We are almost full. Extract stone. Oh. So I'm supposed to be doing stone. What is this? Coal? Can I not put it? I can't. I don't know why it was splitting them up. It said not to get the iron, but I think I can. Ow. It's rude. Eight is a lot. Okay. Skeleton bone. Oh, a new sword. Is that better than the one I have? Oh, it is. Can I trash that? I do. Craft a furnace. see, can I get an old broken elevator? Maybe someone with engineering skills can fix it. Alright. I thought it was a ladder. That building is so cute. It's so well done. Okay, let's get to the workbench. And let's make... Oh. Can you not just... stack. Oh, I didn't pick it up. All right, how many? Two. I should have just brought that up to two. Do that. Oh, there we go. Let me take that. Okay, and let me just put it right there. There we go. Craft a copper bar. Yeah, go ahead and smelt that. Right, there's a copper bar. Craft your house. Alright. How much for my house? Two copper bars, three wood. Oh, I can only make two wood. Right, let me go. Go chop a tree down. Let's get this one. Right, I'm stuck. Let's get this one actually, because I cannot see the bottom of the other one. Ooh, is that a raspberry bush? I love raspberries so much, they're one of my favorite foods. It is. Oh, he has daily quests as well, the fisherman. Those might be easier. Right, let me take those two. Can now craft one more. And then we want two stone. And we want another copper bear. Let me run down and see what that dude as for his daily quest. Because I would very much like to know. I really want to go fishing. More fish stew. Oh, hey matey, can you do me a favor? I've been eating a mackerel for my famous fish stew. Do you have a shop? I can buy a fishing rod. Thank you. There we go. And a cooking station blueprint. I should really go around and look at everyone's shop inventory. Because it looks like they all have really useful stuff. The raspberries are fine. The wood should be up here. No. Here. Right. No, I did not mean to do that. Although, you know, it's not like it's a bad thing. Thank you. Two. You may have noticed a bar below each tool slash weapon. This is its durability bar. When it reaches zero, the tool will be unusable or might even break. If that happens, you will need someone to repair it. You can't repair wooden tools. You can't repair wooden tools or weapons. Tools can also be upgraded. For example, a wooden pickaxe can be upgraded into an iron pickaxe of better quality. There are various benefits from upgrading tools, such as their durability and efficiency. This means that you will have to do less work with a better quality pickaxe, or may even be able to mine new ores. Just like the rest of the tools, equip the pickaxe, stand next to an ore, and click on it to hit it. Most of the time when mining any ore, you can also get stones and coal. Those are very useful materials for cooking and crafting. As a new miner, you won't be able to extract every ore. Stick with stones and copper at the moment, as you can't mine iron. Perhaps Braun will be willing to teach you some things later on. Most of the time, ores will need to be smelted into bars in order to use them as materials in a crafting recipe. In order to do that, you'll need a furnace. You can see this furnace recipe by opening your notebook and selecting the crafting tab. Take the house blueprint. Now it's time to build something much bigger than a workshop. It's time to build your first house. Open your crafting tab in your notebook and select the house blueprint. The blueprints for your structure will need to be crafted in your inventory just like normal items. When you build your house and want to place it somewhere, you'll need to clear the area. You can do this by clearing grass with your sword, cutting down trees with your axe, and terraforming the ground with your shovel. Place your house. The first version of your house is just a tent, but it is all yours. You will be able to upgrade it later on, which will give you extra space inside and various other benefits. Also, sleeping inside your house will give you a chance to rest better. Inside your house, you can place furniture and other useful stuff. In later upgrades, you will be able to craft decorative items, such as different walls and floors with various shapes and colors. Craft and place some furniture inside your house to make it nice and cozy. Alright, let's go. Excuse me. Let's go do that. You know what? Do we have information on every plant? Because it would be nice to know the season that they get planted in. You know, whoops. What are these potato plants? Let's go see if we can craft some furniture. It should be up here. Oh, I'm almost out of stamina. Right, furniture. What is that? A distiller? Looks like a blueberry maker. Okay. I have no wood. That's crazy. Alright. I should have one stamina potion so we can get some wood. I'm praying that this wood is pink. I think the other one was blue because it... Oh. Okay. Gross. It's like a greeny yellow. Alright. It's fine, the blue is cute enough. And I don't actually think that you can make different colored things with different colored wood anyway. So it's fine. Right. Let's get what do these do? They're different types of planks. Alright. What do I need? I need one. I need three. Oh, I can cook stuff. Right. say so cool. Right. And now we're out of locks, obviously. Get my axe out and chop down some trees. Sleep. I needed specifically the normal wood, the oak wood, and I have enough stamina, but I may as well just go to bed. Oh, that table is tiny. Can I rotate it? Up here. Whoa. I don't know about going in there just yet, especially because I'm just trying to water my plants, so let's go look for a river. There was one in the woods anyway, so we can always just go in there. Oh, here we go. There's like a... How do I... Farming 101. I don't... understand. Yep. looks fun. Alright, let's go speak to Captain Farrell about fishing. I love fishing in video games, it's always so much fun. I love it in Stardew Valley, even though I know that's a very unpopular opinion, but it is so much fun to me. I used to hate it, but once you really get the hang of it, it's fine. Although I will say, I get out of practice. You have to get into the hang of it and then stay in the hang of it, otherwise it's gone. Hey landlubber, I need to speak with you about something. Darn it, I forgot. Oh yeah, do you know anything about fishing? Of course you don't. Well, lucky for you, I'm here to teach you the basics. Here, take this wooden rod. I've already bought one. Let me show you how to use it. I guess durability, it's fine. I'll have to use another one eventually. It'd be easy once you get the hang of it. Steak, did he fall asleep? Stay close to the sea and cast your line. The quirk will float and the rest of the line with the hood will go under. Then there is the most essential part of fishing. Don't be falling asleep as you wait for a fish to bite. If you fall asleep, you could end up crashing your boat. You can take my word for that, landlubber. Where was I? Oh yes. When a fish bites, you need to reel the line back in carefully, clicking on the highlighted pieces on time. Also, you need to be quick. If you're too slow, the fish will escape. So you're ready to catch some fish. Yeah, I already have a fishing pole. Catch a fish. Alright. The dog is out in the water. That's cute. How? Do I have to be on the beach? That's a bit odd. Alright, let's come over here and try. Oh, I just clicked on, I clicked on impulse. It scared me and I clicked on impulse. Okay, we have plenty of time, we don't have to go crazy. Okay, I'm not gonna be very good at this. Sleep. tree. Nearly every townsfolk will have something for you to learn to do with their profession. You can see what they have to offer in your notebook when you right-click on the townsfolk and select the tab with the heart. This is the talent tree of the townsfolk. You will unlock talents as you increase your friendship with him/her. Just say them. As you increase your friendship with them through quests, jobs, story missions, and presents. Complete bronze quest to increase his friendship level. After you gain enough friendship, the next talent of bronze tree will be unlocked. He will teach you how to extract iron. This is a very useful talent because you will be able to upgrade your wooden tools to iron tools. Of course, you can't do that alone. You're only able to create tools and weapons made out of wood. Maybe we'll find someone later on who can. Okay, let's go talk with Eva. Ava, I think I've said her name differently every time. I think it's Eva. Where am I going? Up this way. Hello. Hey, how are you doing? How's the new house? Our town is getting bigger already. You may have noticed, but every townsfolk has a role to play here. Everyone has their own profession. We can learn a lot of things by teaching each other new stuff. I suggest you speak with Bron at the mine. He's a bit grumpy, but you guys may be able to help each other. Okay, what's your daily quest? She's got struck. What is this? Oh, I can buy stuff. I wanted her quests. Carrots. She still wants carrots. Maybe I should buy some carrot seeds. No, but we still can't get this to work. Oh, there we go. Okay, let's go water the potatoes and let's find Margarita and buy some carrot seeds. Can we sell stuff to her? We must be able to, because how else would we get crops and stuff? Or not crops, how else would we get money? Sell. I can sell. 28 coins. What about 99 blueberries? A lot. I imagine he would sell, or he would buy the stuff. Would you buy this? You would, but not for a lot. Okay, we want carrot seed. How many do you get? One. Chest. I may as well. Okay, then let's go sell our fish and then plant everything and water everything. And then let's just go fishing for some more fish, to be honest. I don't really feel like going to talk to Bron. I'm wondering if there's an end to this demo. I feel like there's an end to the story. But I don't imagine there's an end to the actual, like, game bit yet. Because if... Oh, 0 coins, really? Alright. It feels like... It's sort of... How would you feel about giving it as a gift? Okay, so I think our friendship went Spike was. That really sucked. Okay, hello, Bron. You need to learn a thing or two. I'll teach you how to extract iron if I like you, though. Those are ancient dwarf techniques. I learned them in my youth back in the White Mountain. Did someone say gold? You know, there's something weird going on in these caves. Just any fish, a mackerel or a cod ought to do. I have a mackerel and a cod. Please let me complete the quest. Yeah. Carp. I read it wrong. Okay. Tools maintenance. I got some tools. Okay, I'll do that. And rock and roll. I need to replenish some stone. Stone ore. now, I should be able to do... Oh, we've got tab 2. Oh my god, there's so much to do in this demo. Jack has something to tell you about a strange incident that occurred whilst he was gathering wood in the Greenwood Forest. If you need to go to an expedition to another area, it is always best to do so in the morning when you are full health and have full stamina to avoid unpleasant surprises. You can always work on something else and go explore whenever you are ready. Okay. Bron, your quest, you need just more iron and copper, and I should now be able to do that. I believe. Right, that was what I learned how to do. Yeah, it was. There we go. Oh, it shows you. That's amazing. That is good game design right there. It shows you that is something you need for a quest. And how many left you need. That's amazing. Okay, I need one more. Let's get it from down here. Bye. supposed to know that, but okay. Like, yeah, they obviously look artificial, but like, they could have been there. Oh, God, okay. Oh, come on, just go in. Oh, we hope you enjoyed playing the demo. Please don't forget to wishlist Pixelshire on Steam and join our Discord to share your feedback and receive exclusive news and updates on the game. Was that it? Can you only play to day 5? Oh. Can I really not? Okay. Well, I guess that's it then. This game was really fun, other than the very abrupt ending, and I'm pretty sure I could have done more. It was telling me to talk to Jack, but I guess 5 days max, that's perfectly fine by me, I think. It is a free demo, you can go ahead and play it on Steam if you want, and you can wishlist it. That really helps out the game developers. Like I said, you can join their Discord. I'm not actually sure what their Discord is, but I imagine you can find it if you just look it up. Yeah, this game was so much fun. I really no bugs. The only thing was the telling me how to sleep after I figured it out myself, but I think that might have just been a me issue. But yeah, this game was really, really fun.